so-called political cartel, corrupt gangster leaders in Nigeria and Africa as a whole. That is the fact. I am going to speak the fact. So I want every member, go ahead, share the freedom word. I am a preacher from God, you know. So I want you to go ahead and share the freedom. Share it. Let them feel how freedom look like. Look at it. This is freedom right here. You see that? This is freedom. I am the example of freedom. I love America. America is the best country in the world, period. No one should doubt that. If you doubt that, don't come to the United States. Stay wherever you are. Why do you think Europeans are coming here? You know what I'm saying? That is number one. We're going to talk about the Senate today. Senate, Nigerian senators, Nigeria Congress, Nigeria House of Assembly, and Edo State Police Commissioner, Esige Police Station, specifically Esige, Esige Police Station. Number one. Then we're going to talk about it. So, brothers and sisters, I want to first of all acknowledge my admin, PFM admin. You all are doing a outstanding job. I want everyone to understand, nowhere is perfect. Anywhere you go, you got to work hard. You got to crawl. If you born a child today, you start sitting down. You know what I mean? From sitting down, then it start crawling. When it crawl, then it start walking. When it start walking, then the sky is his limit. Him or her. You know what I'm saying? So in any organization, no to talk about no profit movement, like my movement. So we are going to meet a lot of things. We don't even know each other. It's very dangerous. You know, we don't know how everyone behave. For us to be able to coordinate ourselves through what we call digital and computer world, so that make us perfect. You know what I'm saying? There's still going to be a gallop anywhere, any life. It's still going to be, but provided you can be able as a leader, you can be able to bring everyone together, that make you a leader. You know what I'm saying? If a state like my state, Edo State, 4 point something million or 5 million, it's difficult for a whole government, Edo State useless House of Assembly. I repeat, Edo State useless House of Assembly. They are dead. They are not awake. They are sleeping. They gave their drug. They are sleeping. They are not functioning. Edo State House of Assembly. You all are listening to me. Speaker of the House of Edo State. You should be ashamed of yourself. You have been silent. You have completely been silent. You have no voice. You have nothing. You have lost control. You cannot even manage a state House of Assembly. Then tomorrow, you're going to come out, vote for me. Then you'll be playing. Hey, we don't win. Oh, hey, I don't quite get a lot. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That's all you're going to be playing. Let me tell you. The word have come. The freedom word have come to stay in Nigeria. Mega Comrade Officer Iranomigo Edegbe have brought freedom to Africa. Anyone can speak however you like. No bagger. Say whatever you want. Whatever you say right here cannot be used or admissible in the court of law. It's freedom. You can say anything. Do not threaten to kill anybody. Do not incite violent or law enforcement. Do not incite anything that has to do with crime against your government. Do not incite uprising against your government. That is why People's Freedom Movement is no violent movement. We have no gun. We have no weapon. We have nothing. What we have is called freedom. And we have cell phone and, you know what they call it? Computer. That is it. So I don't want to go out of line. I'm already out. It happens every time. So I am a prophet of God, who is here to preach the freedom and rescue God's children from oppression, from injustice, from corruption, from poverty, from killings, from kidnapping, from xenophobia, from police brutality, from unemployment, from cat and cheetahs government of Nigeria and Africa as a whole. They are all criminals. You know what I'm saying? That is what I'm here to preach. I want to make one thing clear. Go ahead. Spread the freedom word. Spread the news of freedom, brothers and sisters. We are here to stay. No one can challenge the power of God Almighty. When you have Jesus, and Jesus is behind you, whenever the demons, the Satans, angels of Satans are coming towards you, and you believe in your God, do not believe in any motherfucking pastors who are fake pastors, who does not know why they are there. Oh, God, Jesus.
Hello?
Oh, God. Yes, son, I'm online. Send me a message. Hello?
Dad.
I'm online. Send me a message.
All right.
Mm-hmm. That is my lovely son. So, you can see, this is how I love my people in Africa. For me to even put my son out, for me to spread the news of freedom, that tells you what life is all about. You know what I'm saying? So, that is it. One other thing, I want to let every brothers and sisters to understand. Life is not as easy as you think it. Do not let any government oppress you. I watched on TV a few days ago, and I saw it online. Senators were fighting. They pick up a weapon, a deadly weapon. Even their security guard, so-called corrupt police officers, they joined the senator. They were fighting another one. In the presence of law enforcement, they hit him with a big wood, a weapon. So, then, sorry, brothers and sisters, give me a minute. Okay, so that's good. That is a good news song. I love you. Bye. That's it. So, brothers and sisters, you can see if that senator who we are using a deadly weapon did not go to jail in the state house of, federal house of assembly, in the capital in Abuja, he did not go to jail. He has not been arrested. Whatever it is, I don't care. Tell me how they don't have different justice. Nigerian justice is divided into two, or even four parts. There are one for the law enforcement agency. The bad law enforcement agency we have in Nigeria is police. Police are the worst. All my friends are police, and they are watching me. Even the IG is watching right now. Because if he's not watching, he wouldn't have been able to implement the advice, what I told him 2-3 months ago. I saw him implementing it in Nigerian police force. But the credit is not given to Comrade Ranomigo. It's not given to the mega comrade. But the credit goes to the police officers. It's what I learned in the United States. What Americans have taught me is what I transfer online. Then the IG heard about it. He picked it up. I want to thank him. I am proud of you. You are a good learner. You can learn fast. No one is perfect. So that is one thing. Brothers and sisters, let me tell you, freedom movement is a movement that is here to stay. If you fight against freedom, you're going to lose. No one attack freedom and go free. Wife want freedom. Husband want freedom. Even the political cartel, the so-called elite, the hardliners of Nigeria politics and Africa, the criminals, they all want freedom. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm here in Dallas, Texas. I am free. You know what I mean? I am free. Even friends are afraid to even go close to me. Because they don't want Nigerian government to sit there with me or Edo State governor because they want a favor from Edo State governor. So they are running, as I'm telling you right now. I have given my freedom for people. Let me make one thing clear before I go further. I am not a humanitarian. I believe a lot of people that are in Europe, most of them, like they are just a little group that doesn't know the difference between a humanitarian and a comrade or a mega comrade or a freedom fighter. Some that comment, they don't know the meaning. Please, I'm not accusing you are not educated. Me too, I'm not educated. I am a sixth grader, primary school holder. That's what I am. I am not the beginner of primary school. Aladisheu Shagari was a primary school holder, modern school. He was the president of Nigeria. So that is one thing. Bam. If nothing inspire me in this life, Governor, ex-Governor Adams Oshomule of Edo State, he inspired me, number one. Major Muhammad, President Muhammadu Buhari, our excellency, he has inspired me. Number two, Barack Obama is the head of all. If Governor Adams Oshomule, a comrade, can be able to fight and become a governor of Edo State, I give you, my heart goes out to you. He's a man. No one is perfect. If not Adam Oshomule, I will not be driving in a good road in Edo State today. That is the fact. You can see Edo State people. Don't let no one bamboozle you. Don't let no one kiloki you. All these pictures you are seeing around everywhere in Edo State, these are the contract Adam Oshomule awarded before he left office. You know what I'm saying? Adam Oshomule put everything on the ground. If not Adam Oshomule, who can face 5 junctions? Those that know 5 junctions in Edo State. I am coming to Federa. Who know 5 junctions in Edo State? They said there is Edo witchcraft on top of it. He bulldozed everything. If not be Adam Oshomule, who bomb Moki when Moki they jump from one place to another? They patch everywhere. Nobody. I am just waiting. You know what I'm saying? We have to give credit where credit belongs to. So, I want to thank Governor Obaseki. I saw and I heard the news, but you all said I shouldn't be believing what people tell me. But now that I'm going to praise you, I think you will say people to believe it. When it's favorable to you, you allow others to believe it. But when it's not favorable to you, your internet squad, they will cripple my life. They have cost me more than $30,000. So, which I'm still waiting to be paid. That is our plus pain and suffering. It might go up to $30 million later on if it's not settled immediately. That is aside. You have done a great job. The great job that you did, Governor Nowe Ase Obaseki, for appointing independent investigation on the case that me, Mega Comrade, cry about of Edo State police brutality. So I want everyone, those that know God, I want everyone to believe and see by yourself. This is not Mega Comrade. This is not PFM members. That is the truth. But our problem in Nigeria, brothers and sisters, our problem in Africa are not only the bad leaders. Let us be honest. Our major problem are the media, so-called media, 419 media, useless media. They are our problem. The power of democracy is media. What we now understand as democracy is media. Media is the concrete pillar of American democracy. I researched it. I read about it. What I'm telling you is the fact. I am always concerned about reading disclassified ads. That is disclassified CIA stuff, FBI stuff. That is what I read. So I find out that the media are the power. Nobody wants the media to unleash on them. But Nigerian media have become the most corrupt people. Can you imagine? Since I have been crying for how many years now? How many days? Nigerian media are silent. Even there's a punch news in Lagos. They even said I should pay. I said, I am a freedom fighter. If you want to help my movement, you publish it. I am not going to pay you for publishing it. Instead, I will do the talking. Why would you want me to give you bribe before you say the truth? China's TV. Do you think they have not heard about us? Yes. I have their number. They want me to pay them before they carry our news. RTV, even a guy that I'm praising every day. Every day. Is great Esama Bini that I'm praising every day. His evil station cannot carry the bad things. The bad things Nigerian police are doing. He cannot carry the suffering, the poverty that those state people are going through. Nigerian citizens are going through. NTA is completely dead. God will continue to punish bad NTA executive. God will continue to destroy them. Everybody should say amen to it. NTA, they don't want to say the truth of Nigeria. They are hiding behind a gun. They are hiding behind uniform. They are being protected by the security men in Nigeria. They don't want to say the truth. That's fine. Mega comrade will say the truth. That is number one thing. I want to make sure that everyone see what I'm going to talk about. First off, I want to talk about ESIGIE police station. This is close to my heart. Please, I don't want anyone to be angry. Everybody has saw this video. But one thing that I want everyone to know is that ESIGIE police station have become the bank of Edo State Police Command. You know what I'm saying? ESIGIE police station is the bank of Edo State Police Command. That is the fact. If they think otherwise, the DPO should be removed. If not possible, he should be fired. That is the DPO of ESIGIE police station. So, that is one thing that I want to say. So, no, let me go ahead and show you what happened. Wow, ESIGIE police station. You have come. ESIGIE police station, Benin City, Edo State.
What did he do? That one said he could slap me because I had a record that. Imagine that police say he'll slap me. Man, come on for road. Come for road, madam, I will see person. Then go slap me. Because my lab brother will slap out.
Come on for the police.
Man, I be police. Is this not in you, man? Man, I be police. Is this not in you, man? I have to record this. I'm a patriotic Nigerian. This is inhuman. It's inhuman. I have to record this. You will tell your mommy from what to exact and go.
Okay. You can see, brothers and sisters, that useless woman that was covering that boy, she's a police officer. I want all Edo people, if you know where that woman live, her husband, call her husband to question. You know what I'm saying? And that boy that did this recording, I want you to contact me as soon as possible. I know you are looking at me. For what you did, you need to be rewarded. By one way or the other. Myself, I will personally reward you. That is the fact. Then you see the other one, where the same police department, Edo State, they unleash on innocent market women. You understand what I'm saying? I have shown this the other day. But I just want everyone to see it. Because the other day, they were lying. Okay, you can see that one. Immediately, I know Facebook is stupid. I want everybody to study this. Go ahead and save this message before Facebook take it out, because Facebook are supporting corruption. Facebook do not want freedom. Facebook are against freedom in Africa. They have freedom in America. Facebook do not want freedom in Africa. They always cut up my video because Facebook do not want the truth. Everyone should go to my YouTube account. Mega Comrade Clement Iranomigo Edegbe. Go and subscribe. If you are my follower or you are my member and you do not subscribe, you are not going to get your ID card. That is the truth. Not until I find out you subscribe, you will not get your ID card. We have to spread the word freedom. That is one thing. Let me show you. That is for the police. Let me tell you how police are useless. How some police, Nigerian police, some of them, how money will kill them. Can you imagine? If this police officer that I'm about to show you is still in Nigeria working, Nigerian police, IG, you are watching.
No gangsters.
Hold on, see.
No gangsters. No gangsters. No gangsters.
Okay, you can see that. That is a Nigerian police force. You see that? He want to die for money, corruption. Can you imagine a police officer? If those people that were there could not save life, they could not save anyone. Tell me what AK-47 would have done. He would have killed people. That is what others should practice. Be your brother's keeper. Be your sister's keeper. Be your family's keeper. Don't watch police brutalizing your own brother and say it does not concern you and allow them to kill him. No, brothers and sisters, don't do it. I am begging you. Do not do it. My life is safe. You can see me right now. I am living good. I am not crying for myself. Please, if we can save life, we don't know who is going to be governor tomorrow. If Adam Oshobula of Edo State can do good in Edo State, who could have thought? Governor Adam Oshobula. No matter what he do, if not Adam Oshobula, there will be no road in Benin. That is number one. Let me show you how what Oshobula did that is bad. I will tell you, and I'm going to show you. They say truth is very bitter, but it's good to see, to show the truth. So, let me explain this. This is what Oshobula did. Before Oshobula came into power in Edo State, a governor can be able to determine how many electricity you get in your own state. I want Governor Godwin Oyase Obaseki to be watching now. I want you to listen to it. Please, I am begging you. If Governor Oshobula can start sharing electricity, before Oshobula, there was no sharing of electricity in Benin. NEPA take light. If you are rich, you get it 24 hours. If you are not rich, you get it little, like me. But Governor Oshobula came into power. They embezzled the federal money for electricity. Governor Oshobula and Goodluck Jonathan was the head. They steal all the old money, PDP and APC. I am begging Nigeria, please bring another party. Bring another party, APC, PDP, bad leader. Now God go punish you now. Now God go punish you now. God Almighty go punish you now. APC, PDP, bad leaders. If you are PDP bad leader and APC bad leader, God Almighty is going to set your house on fire. Let me tell you, PDP and APC, they went ahead and in the money after they embezzled in billions of dollars. Nigerian citizens have no choice but to start lighting their house with generator. And bad news for me, this thing happened in Edo State again. This is what Governor Adam Oshobula left for Obaseki. This is not Governor Obaseki fault. If you can take the credit, take the blame. This is it. I want everyone to see it. Let me put it like this.
Like this for the help of here. Generator. Generator. You can imagine they put generator in the kitchen and slept off. You can imagine lifeless bodies on the ground. You can imagine, this is one of the girls.
They are guests
to the house. This one of them, they put on generator and slept off. Put on generator in the kitchen. It was a friend that killed them. This happened in Agarase Street, behind the Winners. Supply Road.
Benin City. This is one of the boys, a very young boy. I think one of the boys that stays with the occupants. Just went off like that. Lifeless on the ground. Can you imagine? This is, I don't know how to classify this. Very horrible. They are lifeless.
Okay. So, you know what? I want to ask one question. Brothers and sisters. If Adam Oshomole, I know you are watching. I've gotten the information. Your boys are watching. If this was your son, will you be happy? Nigerian government, if this man, this young girl, beautiful young girl, if that was your daughter, how will you feel? You know what I'm saying? How will you feel? If this is a girl, to raise a child is not a joke. Those who are parents, to raise a boy or a girl is not a joke. It's very hard. How will you feel? Not even kidnapper, not even courtesan, not even accident, because of corruption. Tell me how you feel, Governor Adam Oshomole. And tell me how you feel, Goodluck Jonathan, so-called professor. You are coming to the United States, collecting awards, one award to another. But you could not tell them the pain you have inflicted into Nigerian citizens. Under your watch, a professor, what do I call it? Corruption exploded. PDP leader, APC leader, how will you feel? That is the question. If I, who is speaking the truth, you want to silence me, who is going to talk? How many are you going to kill? How many before you know enough is enough? A generator, he managed to buy a generator. Why did he put generator inside his own kitchen? I will tell you the reason. Because of criminals, no job. If he put it outside, they will steal it. She has no money to buy another one. With our own little brother in Edo State, Governor Obaseki. This is not your fault. I am going to tell you. If you don't know how to do it, come to Texas. Because of this little boy and this little girl that died, I have a company who is a solar energy company in Texas. As you understand, in Texas, they have the best solar energy company who will negotiate. I have it on my agenda. For 10 years, there will be no electricity failure. You are not going to pay for it. Let me tell you, if you go to Benin City or Nigeria and tell you you're going to pay for it, it's a lie. You're going to pay. We're going to put it under Edo State credit. Then, if the electricity did not fail for 10 years, you pay the balance money. Meanwhile, you'll be making payment every month. Solar energy. And I will give you a land in order of local government. A big land that belongs to my father. I will give it to you free of charge. Install the solar energy into it. I want you to employ, hire Orion first. Orion people first, before Oredo, before Yes and Not, and before Nigeria. You hire them, there will be constant electricity. Forget about Nigeria. Nigeria is gone. Focus yourself on Edo State for now. I am begging you. If you are listening, Governor Obaseki, I have offered you a solution. I am not just doing the talking. I will take you around. If I don't, ask anybody in Dallas, Texas. In the whole United States, they all know me by name. But they don't know me. Some when they see me, they say, oh, we thought you were an old man. Because that is how it is. I made my name almost 15, 17 years ago. I made my name, Mega Comrade. Iranomigo was made 15, 16 years ago. So all this story that you are hearing on the street, they are using me to make name. I don't use nobody to make name. I use my own money to make my own name. I've spent millions of millions of millions. You can never be friend to a millionaire if you are not a millionaire. You can never be friend to a millionaire if they are not getting anything from you. If Nigerian millionaires are not scamming you, they are not enjoying you, they will run away from you. So if you see the billionaires in Nigeria, the millionaires are my friend. Understand, they are getting help from me. You know what I'm saying? That is the fact. So I want you to understand that. Before you make any statement in anywhere, understand that if you minus 17 years out of your age, maybe you were a baby. Then, I'm an old man. And I'm proud to be old. You know? That is number one. So, let me go ahead and talk to Nigeria NEPA. A boy was killed in Nigeria. A wire cut down in Nigeria. They called the NEPA. The NEPA refused to come. And an innocent life were lost. Guess where it happened again? In Edo State. Let me show you what Lagos State government are doing. I am coming. Let me show you something. What Lagos State government are doing. I want every state to practice it in Before anything, this is a woman who will come, who deliver a baby, but before they even get to the bus stop, they call on emergency. An emergency appear. For that work alone, Lagos State governor, I will continue to praise him. Whatever he did wrong, I will tell him. Those that are waiting for me to create problem for him, he has no problem. When you do good thing, I will say it. You do bad, I will say it. Everybody say it. Let me turn it back. See the baby. This baby can become the leader of tomorrow. You see that? That is a good thing. That is an example. In Lagos, Governor of Lagos, God bless you. We love you. I want every state in Nigeria, every governor, that useless governor, that went ahead and buy, governor, I don't know where he come from, and buy wheelbarrow for his youth. I am coming for you. That wheelbarrow you buy, now your children, your fourth, your next generation, We use that wheelbarrow. You want to turn our graduate to a wheelbarrow pusher. I have pushed wheelbarrow in my life. I know how it is. There's no job I have not done. I pushed wheelbarrow. When my father was building a house, I was using wheelbarrow. It's very hard to control. Please, I will come to that. I'm not going to stay long on this phone. It's about time. Let me go to Nigerian senators. First of all, I want to address this. Governor Obaseki, I heard that the Nigerians in London, though you know, I don't know what they call them in London, the reason why they do not speak against you, why they were criticizing me, Nigeria, I want you all to listen. You can see one man that brought out a picture in London, that useless Ewu Meriji, that fool who does not even know where he come from, that animal who call himself Edo, who have not visited Nigeria, visited Nigeria 4 times last year. I would have won last 2 months. Governor Obaseki asked me not to come. I am a smart man. You can't cage me. That is why I have not been to Nigeria. You that have not even visited Nigeria. You went ahead and bring out a video and be showing it on TV. Look at this, look at that. You did not tell anyone or everyone that Governor Obaseki had promised you people land. Let me tell you, Governor Obaseki, Edo State land is not for London Union Organization. If I hear it, if I hear it, you allocate land for those organizations who refuse to speak the truth. As you know, my people, Nigerian people, when I started this show, I was telling everyone that London created this problem. British created the problem of Nigeria. British taught Nigerians how to corrupt, but they don't know how to tell them how to stop corruption. Our billions of pounds are in Britain right now, sitting in their bank. They are using it. They refuse to give it to Nigeria government. They want us to do one paper at the other. And all those bad Nigerians who are studying in London, they have learned the corruption. And the union in London, they learned the corruption. They want to bribe Governor Obaseki and support him. They use him as a patron. Nigeria, listen, you. They use Governor Obaseki as a patron. Now, they want land in return. Edo State land. Let me ask you one question. We have a, what we call ENA in America. We have more than 300 Edo Union in America. Here in Dallas Fort Worth is 3 Union. The one that I break into two, me, I single-handedly adapt the old executive in Edo Association as anyone in Dallas. Then I created another one, Edo Nuwa, who brought Adao Shomule and Dangote to Dallas. I created it. I left money for that union when I left. But as I'm talking now, the money is not there. They drove me, actually. They are corruption. You know what I'm saying? It's not there. How many organizations are you going to give land? Are you going to give 300 organizations in America land? Are you going to give how many union in Japan land? Are you going to give land to the German organization? Edo organization in Italy? ASAN organization? Are you going to give every organization in the whole world land? Be careful. Don't ask for trouble you cannot solve. Save yourself some headache. That land contract is void. V-O-I-D. Void. If they want a land, tell them to come and build hospital. Tell them to come and build clinic. Tell them to come to the media and say the truth. If they want a land, that is for you. My governor, Edo people, you people are listening now. Know when the fire starts. You people will be saying, Iranomigo will be in the matter of thugs. Iranomigo will be in the matter of a kidnapper. Iranomigo will be in the matter of a militant vampire. I am warning you people now. You people should go and advise your governor. Edo Union in London, there will be no land for you, period. No land. Edo land belongs to all Edo people, not the people who are in London. Know them. How many people have you helped? Nothing, zero. When I was helping, there was no social media. I have done my own. Now I am a freedom fighter. I am on one course. The guy that stranded in Nigeria Republic, I have solved his problem with my own money. Then I solved their problem already. I did not ask for anyone money. The money that when you see when I ask for money, you know is for the movement to grow. We need offices. I cannot do it alone. I am not taking people money and start feeding myself. I have a good job. Even right now, a sheriff department is pursuing me, another sheriff department. They want me to come to their department. The officer that are there, and my co-officer is TJ. I keep, the fire is right here with me now. I have not feel it. Let me not lie. Just give me 1 second. Let me bring it. People will see what I'm saying. Me, I don't lie. I say the truth. You can see the fire. I did not even correct the fire. Not to talk of going there. So, if you think I'm not asking for money to feed, if you think whatever that you are doing, you want to use Nigerian resources to enrich yourself. When you are already in freedom, you have freedom. You can go to any country in the world. No one will ask you. I cannot go to Nigeria because I'm speaking the truth. So I am going to tell you, save yourself some trouble. You don't want to be in the list. Please, I am begging you. Let me bring it. If I sign this file right now, do everything, they asked me to return it Thursday. You see, Thursday a.m. When was Thursday? I didn't do it because I am fighting for people. I tell them I don't have time. I kept it there. That if I want to switch department, I have more money. Sheriff department in Dallas, in Texas. So that is the fact. So I am telling you, I have a very good job. I am not asking you for money to feed. When you want to help your people do something, do it on your own. I will not tell anybody again to give money to this, give money to that. Because you can trust yourself, you might not trust others. When one place, when they do mess up, it's going to affect you. So I'm just going to focus on my fighting movement. That is the truth. I find out that those that you stand with, that you help, when they have a little freedom, they will forget where they come from. You know what I'm saying? As I'm speaking right now, Kotisubo is still in jail. Kola Edokpa is still in jail. I know the governor will do a good thing and release them. They sent me a message yesterday. If someone can be in the prison and send you a message, that tells you they know what you are doing for them. When the lawyer called me, I was shocked. I mean, we chatted. Then before we talk, I let them know I am behind them and God is with them. They're going to be free. So let us go to Nigerian Senate. I will talk about that on Wednesday. I will talk about Kola Edokpa Ayi and Curtis Ugbo. But those that don't want to talk about it no more, may God bless you. No problem. Everyone have his own time. Benin people always say, I'm a bookpass neighbor. Or say, Bogyo, my dovey. He must get to your tongue. That is one thing. So I want all Nigeria to understand this. Your senators are the most paid senators in the whole world. Senators, Nigeria senators, are the most paying senators in the whole world. Nigerians are dying in Libya. There is no electricity. Nigerians are dying in xenophobia in South Africa. Nigerians are dying in India, xenophobia. Nigerians are dying in Dubai, xenophobia. But Nigerians are getting stoned in Qatar. But our senator do not want to help. We have three senators from each state. Out of these three senators, the total senators are 109. One from Abuja Federal Capital Territory. Let me tell you, all these senators, I have one man that is good, that I've known. Kogi State, Kogi West Constituency, Senator Dino Melaye, 43 years old. That Senator Dino, God will continue to bless you. Senator Dino, you will live long. Senator Dino, God will continue to bless you. The people of Kogi State will reward you one day. But the rest senators who have not spoken against this barbaric way that our governors, I told you the other day, don't blame Buhari. Buhari is not the problem of Nigeria. Buhari is paying money. He pays all the governor money. The governors are the one embezzling our money in Nigeria. Kogi State senator said it all. They said, you know, our governor is the problem. The senators, some of them are the problem. Okay, look at every senator. Congress have 225 seats by APC. PDP have 125 seats. PDP and APC, others 10. Total House of Assembly, Federal House of Assembly, 469 seats. If these people, they are not even up to 1,000 people, can destroy Nigeria in our hand, 180 million. Don't you know we are stupid? We are foolish. Combine the governor, combine the senator, combine all of them. The military are in our side. The Nigerian military, they are in our side. They want freedom. Forget the police. Police, you don't know where they go. Even my own friend. When trouble comes, you will see that they will be dodging left and right. I tell you, even my own brothers who are police, don't forget police, Nigerian police, forget them. Let's talk about the military are with us. Why do we allow all this, not even up to 2,000 people, to shape our destiny? Why, Nigeria? Why? When are we going to rise up and vote all these barbaric leaders out of office one by one? Why? When is that going to be? When? Why can't you support the truth, Nigeria? You cannot talk. You don't want to support who is saying the truth. What kind of life are you living? You are a graduate. They buy you a wheelbarrow to be pushing. And you are doing yahoo yahoo. How long any woman that is married yahoo yahoo boss have fee for you? What about the computer? If they cripple it, how are you going to survive? That is the fact. So I don't want to stay more than 1 hour. I want to let everyone know I have a lot I have not talked about. Nigeria senators, Nigeria House of Representatives, then Oriowo House of Assembly, Asoro, I will come for you on Wednesday. Honorable Asoro, I will come for you on Wednesday. Hence, you want to destroy Orion or local government. You can never do it. This last election that you won is the last one. I want Adam Oshomule to understand. Please allow Obaseki to work. You can imagine when PDP suppressed your oppression. When you won an election, they took it away from you. We all masses, we fight for you. We were behind you. Then you become a governor. Even our own father, Obasanjo, Amore Joseph, was playing music. But when you become a governor, you say one man, one vote. Where is the one man, one vote? Baba, Osho, where is the one man, one vote? Don't forget where you come from. You have been living in a bubble. Cape Verde Island, begging your Miss Oshomule, the wife of Oshomule. You came from Cape Verde Island. You know how your country is. Your country is a very good country. I'm calling everyone to go there for vacation. Cape Verde is a peaceful place. There's no corruption. Why can't you shape your husband the way your country is? Eh? Please, all those Americans that are calling me before I hang up, if you want to go to vacation in Africa, I want you to go to Nigeria. Let me tell you, I am from Nigeria. When you go in there, connect with the military officials. If you need a bodyguard, if you want anything, sorry, they will play with you. All these Americans going to South Africa, going to Kenya, going to this, there ain't no better place than Nigeria. Nigeria, if you want to go and visit Orion local government, visit Edo Empire. Edo Empire, go to Benin, go to Calabar. You will see how Nigeria is good. You know what I'm saying? Go and visit. All those hip-hop rappers, you all that is going to South Africa, going to South Africa is xenophobia country. You don't want to go there. South Africa is the worst place. They have the highest HIV in the world. South Africa. As you want to fight us with xenophobia, we will fight you wherever you are. You don't want to have HIV and bring it to the United States. Just go to Nigeria, go to West Africa country, go and enjoy yourself. I tell you, don't think about, oh, South Africa are beautiful girls. If you want to see a beautiful woman, go to Unibank. You know what I'm saying? Go to Unilag. Eh? Go to University of Calabar. Then you will see good women. Please, I want to tell you, if you want to do your vacation, Nigeria, Edo State, is good for you. Go there and spend money. The money is too high. When you get there with dollars, you will enjoy. If you want to call us and ask us how you can get security, PFM are ready to provide security for you. We'll contact the Nigerian military officers. They will protect you. Do whatever you want to do. Enjoy yourself. Anything you want to do that is legal, do it. So that's what I want to let everyone know. Please go ahead and subscribe on YouTube. I love you. Subscribe to Clement Iranomigo Edegbe on YouTube. Please, whatever you can do to help us to grow our movement, go ahead and do it. You know what I'm saying? I want to thank every brothers and sisters. On Wednesday, I'm going to be online. I'm going to talk about the Senate. I'm going to say the truth. There's more to come. The truth will prevail. Thank God Almighty, we are all alive. I want to thank brothers and sisters, those that are out there. Please, if you want to criticize me, criticize the freedom. You know what I'm saying? Help our people. It don't matter. Whatever you can do. There's Igbo man. There's a pastor who is in Dallas, Texas, who have built an hospital. He's been doing a lot of things with American money. He does not ask for money from Nigeria. He just asks from America. He's in Dallas, Texas right here. I will ask for his permission. Then when he tell me, I will plug him. Everyone will know him. I love you. God bless you. God bless America. And God bless Nigeria. And God bless your world. I am calling on the British government, French government, German government, all over the world. Please intervene into Nigerian corruption. Corruption have killed Nigeria, have killed Africa. I am begging you to intervene into it before insurgency is in everywhere in Nigeria. That is the advice I have for everyone. Please do not call me in the next 30 minutes. Please, I am begging you. I love you, Mega Comrade Officer Iranomigo Edegbe. God bless you. I'm patronizing United States Air Force. If you want to join the military, join United States Air Force, United States military. They are the best of the best of the whole world. You will have a good benefit. Your children will go to school. You don't pay nothing. When you have children, they will be free. Like my son now, all his children in life, they're going to be trained by United States military. So it's a good thing. I've done good for him. If you want to join, you can see, join it. A father of a military is a military. I am a military family. Myself, I am a law enforcement officer, a security personnel. God bless you. I love you.